So we're just going to talk about the time period before all of this happened.
Okay.
When you're at university, first time you met this guy, and your whole life changed.
I was a student at the top agricultural college in England. But it was a horrible time. In the early 90s, the whole nation was kind of wary of the fact that the Irish Republican Army had declared war.
Bomb 100 pounds of explosives had been packed into a van parked in a narrow side street.
The Irish Republican Army is taking credit for today's mortar attack that landed in the British Prime Minister's backyard.
Caught in a storm of flying glass and debris, the shocked and bewildered victims were taken to the same
today hospital. The IRA warned that this weekend's attack would be followed by more bombings as long as the British government continued to occupy part of Ireland.
Among us were terrorists who were planting bombs to disrupt our way of life. There was a large Irish population at the college, and the college was under some sort of surveillance or suspicion because a student was gun-running for the IRA.
The 20-year-old student from the Harper Adams Agricultural College had been stopped by the police. They found two Kalashnikov rifles, 100 rounds of ammunition, and traces of five different types of explosives in his car.
It seemed a bit surreal that this terrorist had been found in our midst. After that, completely out of the blue, one of my Irish friends committed suicide. Why on earth would such a great guy do that? I went to the pub. I was talking to the new barman, Rob. I'd got to know him in the last few weeks. I told Rob about my friend's death. And he said, "Do you really think your friend committed suicide?" "Your friend didn't commit suicide. The IRA shot him." He saw something he shouldn't have seen. "Well, what did my friend see?" He said, "You know how to make a bomb, don't you?" I was like, "Not really, no." "The main ingredients are fertilizer and diesel." "Where'd you get fertilizer and diesel?" "They're both used on farms." So the student here that was running guns, do you think he was acting alone? These people work in cells, and there's still a cell to find. Of course, I asked, "Well, how do you know this?" "I'm not who you think I am. This is all just a cover. I'm an MI5 agent." Rob said what they need is somebody in the college to help expose this IRA cell. "We've seen your record, and it's clean. We're gonna use you." There was a bit of me that was excited. The idea of taking some terrorists off the street, sure, I'm all in favor of that. He said, "How many fights have you been in?" And I said, "I'm not a fighter, I avoid conflict." It became apparent that I needed some training. Rob showed me how to jab, as well as training me to throw a punch. Rob trained me to take a punch. You need to be able to take it from whichever angle it comes from. I can't remember how many times he punched me. And I had a small sense of relief that I'd taken it, that I was passing the test. I was tasked with writing down the number plates of all the cars in one particular part of campus closest to the nitrogen fertilizer store. And then Rob had me write down a list of names of people I was suspicious of who had access to fertilizer. My housemate Jim was on that list. Rob and his bosses suspected Jim. Jim's one of them. The idea that Jim was involved with the IRA was shocking and hard to believe, definitely, but not beyond belief. Me and Jim lived in the same house as Maria and Sarah. Sarah was my girlfriend. Rob said his bosses were telling him it was not safe for us to be there anymore. We're in grave danger, and we need to go, now. Not just me and you, but the girls as well. So I said, are you going to tell the girls as much as I know? No, it's too dangerous. They could put the operation in jeopardy. How on earth are you going to get the girls to go then? You're going to have to lie to them to save their lives.
Maria and I were summoned to the pub because he needed to tell us something, and he sat us down and said that he'd got cancer and that it was terminal. The thought of him dying, yes, it was very, very sad. Not only was he my boyfriend at that point, but he was also a friend.
They were devastated, Sarah particularly. And I had that sickening feeling of having just told the most disgusting lie. It's definitely the worst thing I've done in my entire life.